ideally, the selection of the power should come at the same time as the selection of the main processor, the main FPGA, the main DSP in the system. So it means very early on in the process. And usually the providers, the makers of these SoCs or the FPGA, they have power estimators, power calculators that they provide when you select your FPGA or your processor, and you know what features you expect, what functions they will perform, then you can already estimate the power very early on. So then you can already have an idea of what type of module you will need to power these, how much space they will take, where you can somehow place them on the board. And so this, ideally, this is where this should happen, at the selection of the boards. In many cases, the power is for the people that are not expert in the power world, but are expert in the digital, the content, or the end application. The power supply is either something they don't even think about, so it's complete afterthought. Comes at the end and said, "Oh, but we have to power this FPGA. We have to power this big processor. Okay, let's find something. Is there a redesign? Is there a module that can do everything?" Or they just completely underestimate it because they are not expert. They don't know. So it's really a big challenge, and that's why we develop these kind of products. So what they expect from us is that we come with the power supply solution that they don't have to think about. They just expect us to give them a complete solution that has to be working by itself, and they don't have to develop anything. The progress that all the digital, the processors and SoCs and FPGAs, DSPs, etc., all this digital thing I've made, the amount of computation they can do, it's just amazing how it has improved. But this goes at a cost, and the cost is you need to power this. You have to supply energy to them to perform this. And the challenge really is, how do you make everything stick on one board? For this, that's why we developed this very high power density modules, DC-DC power modules, that you can just stick there, and they go together with the digital, but they don't need any extra work to put them in place. You just put them here, it works, and then you can concentrate on digital, which is the heart of the product. So yeah, this is the biggest challenge really is, how do you accompany the scale of improvement of all this digital power? The discussions we usually have with customers about power, in many cases, comes too late. They've already selected their main part, they already have the complete size of their solution, and suddenly they realize that they need to stick power somewhere in there, and they really overlook the fact that these processors, these FPGAs, they really need many different rails. There are so many different voltages, and sometimes it's the same voltage for different pins, but they have to be separate because they have to be filtered out individually, they have to be separate. So they completely underestimate this.